Hey guys, and welcome to episode 29. And this episode is going to be pretty awesome because we're actually going to be doing the arena open today. Let's flip one of these quests here, and then let me show you the deck. So the deck here is going to be Azorius Control. I like this deck in the format. I feel like it tackles a lot of the popular decks that are going around. I have a total of 7 board wipes in the deck: Doom Scars and Devastating Masteries. And what I especially like about Devastating Mastery is the hidden mode of only paying 4. Yeah, it basically just bounces to impermanence, but sometimes that's all you need. A lot of the times, my aggressive opponents would just play a couple aggressive threats and just leave that to my own devices, and then it just puts too much pressure on me. So sometimes I just have to interact with both at the same time, and the only way to do that is by wiping or paying the student cost, I believe they call it, for this, and just allowing them to bounce their permanents. And sometimes against mono green, for example, they have tons of different kind of permanents. They have treasures, they have clue tokens, they have enchantments, and a bunch of creatures. So a lot of the times they'll just even if they have a ton of creatures and they get to bounce and I need to do 2 things at once, I could just let them keep their 2 best things, have a counterspell ready, and then wipe the rest, and I'll be okay with that. So a lot of utility with Devastating Mastery that I haven't really seen people use it as. Imrith, I really like this against the other dragon decks. It's bigger than all the other dragons being played, the Egg and Voltspan Dragon, and it's really hard for those decks to get rid of them. The 4 mana ward, as long as it's untapped, is a pretty big deal. Usually it costs like 5 or 6 mana to try to get rid of it, and with 1 counter spell is usually enough to protect it. Then we got the Memory Deluge here and Devious Cover Up. Devious Cover Up just to cycle all our interaction that we're going to go through right now. And Memory Deluge is just the best card selection in Standard right now. Divide by 0, really powerful interaction spell. Saw It Coming, just to counter everything. 3 Fateful Absence, just to get rid of the early pressure or any planeswalkers that just managed to sneak through the board. Sunset Reverie is a really awesome card. I've been really impressed with it. It's been keeping me alive, keeping my life total high. And I cycle through this card a lot more often than I thought I would, since I'm a control deck and I like keeping cards in my hand. Test of Talents, just great against any other Is It deck that we're going to be going against, or usually I could find a target or 2 in the other decks. Fateful Mending is there just to cycle all the bad cards in case Test of Talents is really awful, or Fateful Absence or the board wipes end up being bad. I could just cycle them away and just look for the more meaningful interactions. We've got 2 Hall of the Storm Giants and a Cave of the Frost Dragon here, just to put pressure and end the games quickly if we feel like it's going that way. Because I do have a tendency to end the game quicker if I feel like the opponent is dead in the water. Alright, so we are going to be playing best of 1. So our sideboard is just going to be nothing but lessons, 2 sciences, 8 teachings of the archaic, 1 intro to philosophy. I don't believe in playing 2 of these. It's hard enough to get the first one going, but getting 2 in a game is really tough. So I got a different draw spell in there. Intro to Annihilation and 2 mascot exhibitions. So yeah, we'll see you guys in the game. Right, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I added the sleeves there because they look pretty awesome. And this is a pretty keepable hand. add Fateful Absence and Sunset Revelry to stabilize things if things get crazy, or Fateful Mending to cycle those away if these turn out to be bad cards. Bit too soon to speculate, but it looks like we're playing against an Is It deck here. Oh, interesting. We're not. Just play lands and go. That's fine with me. I'm 100% fine playing this way. I guess we kill that now before it becomes a problem. Thin out our deck, I suppose. I don't know if we want that, but. Get a planes here because we want four planes, four white mana for the Devastating Mastery. Then we could foretell that. That leaves up Fateful Mending, which I think I'm going to use. Have Fateful Absence to discard to it. And a revelry. I think here I play a tap because either way I could only play one spell. Well, this way I could play Test of Talents and saw it coming. But I am planning to Memory Deluge here. Yeah, I have made the mistake of not taking the graveyard one. I wonder if my opponent will do the same. No. No luck. Okay, so no memory deluges for us. Which is okay. I have three counter spells now. So I'm okay for now. Then here I could even cycle. Yeah, I think I'd rather just do that. I don't even care about getting the creatures. I still have two counters up, which is really good. I like my hand against blue-black control right here. Just a bunch of counter spells, nothing's gonna happen, so. Good. Not looking to play the Storm Giants just yet. I don't have the mana for that at the moment. Opponent's just discarding. He probably has a bunch of counter spells in his deck too. Okay, first non-land, that's okay. Should I get rid of his? I think so. Let's just see what he's working with. going to negate. Okay, that just leaves me up with one mana, but that's okay. Feeding Hope divided by zero, Massacre. See what his deck is working with. Puppet Stitcher, Holdren's Epiphany. So he's going for that combo to create a bunch of creatures. Okay, this seems like a winnable strategy. Ah, I forgot to get the one in the graveyard. As I said that, I do that. That's hilarious. Do I want to cycle? No, I'll draw my card, see what I get. I'll use this one. Now I kind of wish I used the other one, but it's okay. So that lets me hold up everything, right? So that works out. Their Hall of the Storm Giants is gonna get annoying though. Doomscar, that's something to pitch. I could do that at the end of their turn. Arun's Epiphany. He only has 2 mana. Let's see, I do want some. Two saw it comings, maybe not the test anymore. Maybe, yeah, I do want the test back. Not that, and hold the Storm Giants here. Cards shuffled back in. That was a perfect draw, actually. Very happy with that. Specific mana up, seems. Need those two. Imrith. Seems like a good draw. don't think I can play it now. Yeah. That's just gonna make the game a lot tougher, that memory deluge. I might actually have to give up the Emerith here, depending on what my opponent plays. Okay, I'm not too worried about the Leer, I suppose. But maybe I should be. See what we get with Faithful Many, because we're gonna do this anyways. Alright, Leer resolves. Seems like a pretty solid answer to things. Is deciding whether to use his man land or not. Yeah, I would. Let's play Emerith and see what happens. I guess that's what happens. I already have an answer with Devastating Mastery to the Mascot Exhibition. See, she saw it coming to the gate. They're running out of counter spells. With nothing but just a bounce. Should I attack? No, they have that bounce. I guess might as well make them use it, right? I only have one counter spell anyways. No, since I could answer it with the mastery, I'll let that resolve. That was a good draw. That's gonna let us put pressure back on our opponent. Oh, I messed up. See, this is one of those moments where I could have let him have me have mastery back. Alright, do we think opponent has multiple counter spells? Do we need the saw coming to resolve? I think we do. Alright, not the saw coming. The devastating mastery. But I think we definitely do. Force him to have it. Okay, so now we're both out of counter spells. See, if I played it for 4, I would have enough for divide by 0. And all they would have is just their Mihawk Master, Massacre out, so. Let's see what we draw here. Wasn't bad. Take another big hit here. I think here. That was a really good draw. So I'm going to take 5, go down to 1. I have to counter the fading hope. Should I just counter divide? Do I have anything that I want? Another devious cover up? Yeah, that kills me. I don't think. Right, I do this. And then he just plays it again. Okay, just put it. Yeah, you got the test of talents on my right cards. Good games, opponent. That was really awesome. Alright guys, we're no strangers to defeat, so let's go on. This is an awesome hand, I'm gonna go ahead and keep. tap land go. Depending on what they play here, foretell something different. Interesting, maybe it's a vampire deck here, so could go. Hide the fact that I can play Doomscar on 3. And then still be able to hold up mana for Saw coming. Them not playing anything here would be really bad. I don't think they could afford to do that. Oh wow. Okay, so we got away with something there, so we're just gonna play Deserted Beach and pass the turn. Turn 3 play. Just gotta counter it. Don't want to worry about too much about it. Drawing a lot of land here. Let's just pass the turn here. Could have let the resolve, but I just want to keep the board clear right now. I do have a cycle with Reverie, but I can still get value out of that later. I think I'm just going to cycle with Faithful Mending here. Just passes, really good for me. I think here I'll pitch a plains and an island, funny enough. The line here, I don't think I'm going to cycle just yet. I now have Fateful Absence and Mending. Alright, that's good. He doesn't have protection and no other creatures out. Alright, gonna cast Faithful Mending now. See what we get. Wonder if our opponent just has connection issues right now. I think here I'm going to discard the Deluge and the Pathway. And then just kill the vampire now. Don't want them to get too ahead. Let them draw a card. I suppose this turn we could cycle. We could add two creatures if we saved it, but then we would have been completely tapped out here, and I don't like that idea. We draw a counter spell here, we hold it up. No luck. I think I'm just gonna play the Hall Giants here. I should have played the Cave Dragon actually. Just for the four sources, in case I draw that Sweeper, Devastating Mastery. Because now I have to play the Island to Memory Deluge for seven. Then after I deluge, it's pretty much set in stone here. My opponent just hasn't been doing anything. I'm sure he has tons of removal spells, but not in his hand. Alright, there's a white source there I could just play right away. I also could have blocked it if I played the Cave of the Frost Dragon, but that's alright. Seems pretty good right now since he doesn't have a lot of action going on. Maybe he could discard some removal spells in his hand. Okay, now I get some Memory Deluge. So, yeah, you could say there's a lot of action here. I'm going to take in Emrith. Actually, maybe not even Emrith. Maybe Fateful Mending and a Devastating Mastery. Now we get to just wipe the board here. Playing my Caves, and this is a deck where I don't need a million mana. Like, I'm not playing against another control deck, so I don't need like 15 lands out to do stuff comfortably. I'm already at that spot, so I could start discarding these lands. another creature. Okay, good set of cards there. I like test the talents to protect my creature lands, because it seems like I'm going that route. This is one of those moments where I just want to play this. I am already winning, so maybe it's alright to just play that and then hold up a counter spell if I draw one. Yeah, I'm going for it. Then if I draw an untapped land, hold up test of talents. It's not gonna protect me from much, but maybe I draw Nagi as well. Alright, well that's a test of talents bubble creature. So that's good for us. This one's gonna be scary for us since it has haste. Gotta make sure you get that graveyard one. Access to the entire hand, so let's see what our opponent decides to do. He's gonna build his board out. No, he's actually playing it pretty safe, which is good. Turn. Kicked. So let's see, do I have stuff I want to get back? Just one sock coming, so I'm not gonna use the cover up yet. I want to get value out of all my cards here, so. Okay, could have saved that land here and just pass turn. Save it for Fateful Mending. Get the Emrith now. Let's get rid of the Field of Ruins. Just both field brands. I don't think they have any man lands. And I already have two out. Alright, so let's just foretell these two cards and pass turn. Have a lot of removal spell in their hand to go through. I think here I play Emrith though. Only because I have 7 mana up now, so I could divide by 0 and have a devious cover up. And it's going to take a lot of mana for my opponent to get rid of it. counter it like that, and then I still have Divide by Zero and Devious Cover Up. Which I am going to counter that. Get my counter spells back. And, yeah, just three. I don't need anything else. Now I play my land attack. Gonna open my dragon up, but I get to draw two cards, and I think it's worth it. Let's go ahead and Memory Deluge first and see what we get. They tapped out most of their mana. Pretty good, actually. So I'm gonna get Saw It Coming. And what else do we have open? We have Saw It Coming open. Oh wait, we have everything open. That's disgusting. I'll get Memory Deluge. And I'll Saw It Coming. Then get Mascot. Start any of the game now. Now we have Divide by Zero up. I mean, do we even care? I think, yeah, we should. Mascot. Okay, that resolves. All right, unless our opponent has a removal spell. I think they're dead next turn. I'm gonna go for the kill. Especially after that counter draw. Alright, good games, opponent. Alright, so we really need to draw mana. If we just draw at least one more, we have Divide by Zero to go get Sciences for more. And the Revelry to cycle. So, I'm gonna keep this. Gotta play the pathway on the white for the Doom Scar. That way, any land we draw is viable for it. Alright, we did get there. We are playing against Mono White. So, getting all these board wipes is really good for us. Really hoping for a land next turn. Should we take one more big hit just to... One more big hit here. Hopefully they smell blood in the water. Oh, thank God they didn't have another plane. Oh, wait. Faceless Haven could activate Faceless Haven. That's gross. I have the Faithful Absence to deal with that. Alright, so we did get there. How do we play this? I think we play it like this for the life. Now they play Haven again. I'm just gonna block here, block there. Take one from the aspirant, and then Doomscar everything, and then hold up a Saw It Coming. Saw It Coming or Faithful Absence for one of the Havens. See how our opponent wants to do this. This is going to be a really interesting game. Maybe my opponent's thinking about using removal spells here. While they can, I mean, the only creature I have is hard to use removal spells on, especially for a weenie deck. Interesting. So let's block like this. Doomscar them. So that worked out even better. They got a Devastating Mastery to cost a million, but it's alright. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine too. Here I'm just gonna Faithful Mending. Answers for two of them right there. But I do need land just to play. No, I should be fine. There, and I got my land anyways. So let's wipe again. Just go ahead and kill that. Okay, that's in combat, so that's gonna go away. Oh, actually, no, he can use it now. That's pretty sweet. But I have all my counters up. I'm at 12. Looking pretty good here. Him playing another Haven, though, does kind of suck. Let's just hope that's all he does. Let's go for the easy counter there. And let's see, should I divide right now? Yeah, if I divide now, and I get a land for mascot. Oh, that would have been so good. That would have been so good. I would have played that, and then they would have had hardly anything. Or should I just counter that? If I counter that, I won't have any mana up left. So yeah, I'll just let that resolve and see what they do. Okay, so I'll use this now. That way it doesn't hold my mana hostage. Give me a land. Yeah, that's fine. Let's divide by 0U. I'm going to go ahead and take a teachings. Let's just pray for a land for once in our lives. Oh, no such luck. No such luck. I still only have 6 mana. That's unfortunate. I think I just dig for a land. That was really unfortunate. Wow. Okay, so I'm just gonna take a hit for 4 here, it looks like. See what my opponent decides to do, because they could play Brutal Cathar. Okay, that's fine. There's the Haven, yeah. I mean, we're gonna be taking that hit no matter what. And he's passing it over. Let's see, got there on the land, and what's he discard here? Do we wanna just discard a cover up? Probably not, huh? I mean, but counters are bad. Alright, I will discard the cover up. I'm not gonna be greedy here. And then let's go ahead and play mascot and see what they go for. They could go for a huge, whatever that guy's called. Breath Trump blockers for days. He has 6, so you could do it for 2, making that a 3-3. I have a 4-4 to block. Let's see, what's the wording on Cathar? That's pretty good. You just get rid of the 4-4. Field of Ruin is going to force him to play out his cards, though, but he knows about the Devastating Mastery, which is funny. Okay. Here, right, that's just 1 point of damage. Then I'm taking I don't have a reason to play anything. You can't go for a huge creature there, but that's first strike, that's cool. I wonder if he's gonna do that. If he does, I mean, I'm good at Devastating Mastery, of course. Oh, 1 second. Sorry about that. My pizza just got here. He's gonna go to attacks. Okay, just walk right there. That's fine with me. Okay, let's faithful mending here. Let's get rid of Test of Talents. Go ahead and get rid of his Faceless Haven. Just hold off just a little bit longer. So that means I'm going to foretell this. Play a Sunset Revelry, and I think I have all the boxes ticked. Which is really good for us. We'll foretell that because the opponent doesn't have any counter spells. We only have one, so we don't need to. Alright. Good game's opponent, I was heading that direction. Alright guys, so it's a little over 10 minutes now. Sucks, man. I thought we had a lot more time. It's only 4 p.m. where I'm at, or it's going to be 5 p.m. I thought we had a lot more time to play these games, but it seems like everyone's done. Nobody's putting in any more time. I'm gonna stay on the queue and see if anything changes. But hopefully we have more time to play. Alright guys, we're 30 minutes into this and it doesn't seem like it's meant to be. So yeah, unfortunate that we didn't get to play more games. Kind of a waste of gems. I did get sleeves, but is that really compensation? Very unfortunate, but I'm not just gonna sit around here all day waiting for this to queue up. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Alright guys, I don't know what happened there. I went to go play some other games just to finish my daily wins, and it took forever to queue up too, so I restarted and decided to try the open, and I got into a game. So yeah, let's continue this. We're gonna go ahead and keep this. It does seem like it's a control deck. Just go get rid of the cards that we don't necessarily need. I think I'll be able to get mine off, so I'm just gonna go click on it. Then let's get rid of the planes and the revelry of our own. Pass turn. You have a couple of interaction spells here. Just keep passing the turn, we're not in any rush. Neither is our opponent. Play a Field of Ruins. If they play a creature land, I'll just blow it up right away, then I'll buff our decks. Oh, the chess guy, it seems. Test of Talents seems like it's going to be really good in this matchup. Yeah, that's fine, especially since they played a land already. It's basically only going to be a draw one. Like they're protecting their epiphanies here. Wonder why that one's separated. Separate piles. I mean, I could just test the talents then and just see where it goes. Or I'll just test the talents then. Span Dragon, Emirius Call, Sacred Fire. No, I wonder if he's playing that one mana Firebolt. I'll just get a mascot. Just put the pressure on them now. Is welcome to take extra turns here. If they copy another Elrond, I mean, they just win the game here, right? Alright, what is my opponent? Oh, he's just going for the win. Like that, that's 6 damage. I actually need a white source. I didn't even realize I needed a white source there. He actually had a third one in hand. Yeah, that kills me. It had to be exactly that. Wow, what a drop by our opponent. Alright, good games. Alright, if this was ladder play, I would definitely keep this, but since this isn't, I'm going to take a mulligan. I think I need more interaction. Sunset Rovery, which I think I'm going to use now. Oh wow, actually I didn't even see that. That's fine. I think he will take the blocks. Funny enough, we're winning our race here. It. My dreams of racing ended foggy. Yeah, I'm fine blocking like this. It looks like they need the land, but I'm okay. Reduces them to 21 during plot. I'm okay with that. just cover up. I don't have any reason to do anything else at the moment. Now I do have to be careful with how I play this. Let's see. Guess I just have to do this now, because then I'll never have another chance. If I tap out for a spell here, they're just going to destroy my field. I won't get a chance to. I won't get a chance to kill that again. It still lets me Fateful Mending, though. No rush to do anything here. I'm just gonna continue letting the opponent attack me. My opponent hasn't really done anything. I'll fetch Fateful Mending again. Okay, that was pretty good draw. Yeah, let's just Doomscar everything away and let's just see what our opponent does, because they have to commit more stuff to the board here. Could have waited more, but let's see how they learn here. Okay, they always get this card against me, it's not that great. Which is really good, it feels like a wasted pickup on their part. Now if they want to do that, they have to, I'm going to get teachings here for the draw 2, potentially draw 4. Now they have to use a treasure to use the science. So they have 7. A draw 3, that would be really cool. And it is. How awesome is that? Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and play Island and hold up Counterspell and Memory Deluge. Valky, I think maybe I just counter it, but I don't know if there's anything I want. It's just a couple cards here. Yeah, I think I'll just counter it just for the sake of countering. Just get, I don't even get anything, I'll just counter it. Maybe they have a second play here to get. Is doing absolutely nothing to us, so this is really good. I'm gonna counter that because I don't want them to draw my cards. exactly how I want to play Magic. Big Deluge now. And I already have another Deluge here, so I think I'm just going to take another, or a haul actually, just to start, just in case our Emrah doesn't follow through. Tied up, so I do it right away. Okay, you did that for the trigger, that's efficient. So let's make my deluge now. Completely tapped out. Let's get divide by zero, another mastery. We don't need it. Just back up. That's what tends to happen towards the lake. Just have so many spells for backup. Here I have 10 mana up, that leaves me 2 interactions. Alright, I can play it right now. The only thing that gets us here really is another massacre. Mihawk massacre. Okay, let all these little things survive. Bounce the divide. And then here I could just get mascot exhibition. Game. Here they have to play another massacre or some type of board wipe, which I could just divide by zero. Something like that. Okay, they need to kill my. Yeah, I would have. No, I guess not. Because it would have taken out. It would have been a 3 if I attacked with the land. Past turn, there's very little my opponent could do now. Yeah, you can do that. That's our root counter. Efficient for efficient's sake. All right, good games, opponent. seems like a pretty good hand against a aggressive deck. Let's see. So we are playing an aggressive deck and get the Doomscar to go with the Mastery. Mastery in here, thinking that's my avenue to victory, but it's already the Doomscar I hidden away here. So this is gonna be a nice Doomscar here. I am gonna be taking a lick here, but it's alright. I got healing with Revelry and Mending. I guess they didn't want me to stabilize, which makes sense. Wow, okay. So let's go ahead and play a land. Doomscar. Jack-o'-lantern. Interesting card to be playing for sure. Let's go ahead and get rid of the Mastery so far away from us. Let's see what our opponent decides to take here. This could be saddening to see another Doomscar. Such luck on the land here. This is unfortunate. I don't know if I'm supposed to mend for a land there, but I think I'm gonna Doomscar and risk it. I think I have to Doomscar here and just take 4 on the chin. Hopefully my opponent just plays a card. So I have Revelry and Mending. Okay, this will give me blockers for if they play the a creature. Scar here. Alright, I'm surviving, but just barely. I'm very prone to double block here. I'm okay double blocking here. That means that Sunset Revelry got rid of a creature too, an aspirant. Did just for the creatures and life. Now I have a blocker for the Haven this turn, and I'll have it up to be ready to block. That's fine that it tapped me like that turn. I mean, yeah, that's fine that it tapped me out that way that turn. But I would like a Field of Ruin up. Weird, I wonder why he did that. Here, and I'll just take out the gym like that. If they don't play anything else, I'm just gonna Memory Deluge here, and this would be really good. Let's see, I already have a Doom Scar, but I guess another Board Wipe doesn't hurt. I think I get the land here. I don't think I need the revelry. But maybe it is safer just to take that. See, I'll take the revelry. Just, how greedy do I want to be? Yeah, I'm pretty greedy. I'm just going to take the deserted beach here. Just hit pass. Have a island to discard. Big deluge now. Let's get side coming and divide by zero. We have an Emrith here to win the game with. Wipe like that and hold up two counter spells. Oh wow. Guess we'll hold up one counter spell. We have to use the two mana one because I still want to hold up the Field of Ruin here. Yeah, that resolves. actually bounce that. Wait until the end of their turn. That way, in case they do drop something, they can't play it. That doesn't kill me. Souls. And turn. See what our opponent decides to do. Resplendent Angel. It's interesting. He goes for the attack, that's kind of interesting. Just could go ahead and kill that. He can play another creature, I suppose. He's playing a weenie deck. Just gets more draws at it though. Take the 2 extra damage, but he actually takes it all. Alright, opponent just ends it. Good games, opponent. Alright, so I could work with this. I can interact with a lot of aggressive decks with this hand, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep. Are we playing? Is it interesting? Another blue white control. zero. That's a good one to name. What is an excellent one to name? Let's go ahead and pass the turn. I'm not too sure what my opponent's playing. Really interested. That gave me a target with the absence, which was nice. Do the same. My hand is so bad against this. I think now while he's tapped out is my only chance. He could board wipe still. That'll be good actually. Just board wipes. But like I said, like what else is my hand gonna do? I can't do anything against him right now. My hand's awful. I'm not gonna lie, the extra turn wasn't that impressive.
Second here, second there. Who's counting?
Wondering if I should even tap out for this. Should have sacrificed if he was going to do that. Gets rid of all my other divide by zeros and now he. I mean, what's he gonna do really? Let's go attack. See what he does. Okay, putting my dragon out there because if he gets rid of that, I'm just gonna devastate mastery it. We'll see if my opponent wants to ultimate.
If this is hard, my battle over. Let's hurry to the.
Okay, that's a block I could definitely work with. See if my opponent can. Okay. Interesting block. Decision to activate that. To activate, that's funny. But he doesn't. It's interesting. I don't have enough to play Amareth and have a Field of Ruin, so I'm just good. Looks like we got our opponent scared to attack. That's a decent draw. It's end turn. Yeah, actually, we don't want to try to get them. Give them up. Back. Well, I think we have to try and hopefully this gets counted. player opponent only has divide by zero. Ooh, it's just a talent, so just a talent. Yeah, that's a good game. Good game's opponent. Well, guys, we did get to 4 wins, which is 800 gems, not a lot. But, we did kind of got screwed over with that last game. Just drawing all sweepers, all removal against a control deck, which was really bad. That it looked horrible right from the start. So, I think my deck is well situated for tournaments like these. They just get there on the draw. Hopefully you guys have better luck, or you did have better luck, and I'll catch you guys next time.